conditioned floor area versus TFA. This is just metrics. The German treated floor area is based on the German rental code. And based on the German rental code, you can count some areas as 100% square footage, some areas at 60%, some areas at 50%, and some areas at zero. And what people were doing was taking a lot of time figuring out what the treated floor area is of this building. Now, the software that was set up was based on this treated floor area. So you had to do it to get the accurate results. You have to have an accurate treated floor area calculation to enter into the software. Garbage in, garbage out. If I have the wrong number going in, I'm gonna have the wrong answers coming out. So I got to go through this calculation. On larger buildings, this calculation can be very time consuming. Now, in the FIA standard, it's a similar standard, but they're taking interior conditioned space. So it's a very much easier calculation for people to make. It's just total interior from the inside of the thermal envelope. It's that total interior conditioned area. So, you know, it doesn't really matter whether you do this one or this one, as long as you're using, as you know which one the software takes and you put that in there. Now, the interesting thing is for energy use intensity, which is how we talk about energy use in the US, we use outside of the envelope, not even outside the envelope, but outside of finishes. So we are using gross exterior area for our EUI calculation. So it's really interesting when you start crossing over between different metrics. Like if somebody tells me, I've got an EUI of 16, that's really great. Well, that's an EUI of 16 based on the North American convention. When I translate it back to the TFA convention, you have an EUI of like 20, 22, right? So, you know, it's just a way, it's the same number, it's the same energy use, right? That hasn't changed. It's just how you look at it.